So the typical symptoms patients with scleroderma associated myopathy get are muscle weakness, muscle fatigue, muscle pain can also occur, especially because they can get fasciitis, stamina, muscle stamina. So the even some of my patients who are runners or very active will notice, I just can't do as much. Like I have a patient who's a cyclist and he would be able to cycle for 20 miles, but he noticed that the muscle endurance could be as subtle as this. Just he could get to like 19, 18, miles, but then he's like, wow, this is a little abnormal because I could be doing at least 20. So you can have subtle symptoms. So if patients who are more aggressive with their exercising or they're very active person, they will just notice subtle decline in their muscle endurance. But certainly you can have overt muscle weakness with severe weakness as well. And then the other thing would be shortness of breath can also occur because the diaphragm is certainly a muscle, so you can get respiratory weakness. And our patients will say that they get more short of breath going up a flight of stairs. Also, shortness of breath certainly can not only mean that you have diaphragmatic weakness, but also potential cardiac involvement. So we've described that a specific group of patients, a subset of patients with fibrosing myopathy can have more cardiac muscle involvement because the heart is also a muscle, and that could potentially lead to non-ischemic cardiomyopathy, which can lead to shortness of breath, lower extremity swelling, and things like this. It can happen quickly over weeks. Typically, it's usually subacute, several months. I do have patients where everything happens all at once, meaning they get this weakness in the skeletal muscles and they get shortness of breath and then they also get cardiac involvement and they have problems swallowing. In those cases, when we see these type of patients, we sometimes will even admit them to the hospital because so many things are happening all at once. But then there's also the other spectrum where you can just have mild weakness and subtle decline in muscle endurance, and that can certainly be seen in the outpatient clinic setting. So it's important to gauge that, and I think a very thorough history and physical exam by your rheumatologist and the appropriate workup will be very helpful to determine that.